Back to the Sweet Pea Diaries. We are back with another video. So we have been covering One More Chance over here at the Sweet Pea Diaries. That is the reality show that is currently playing on Zeus. It is a dating show that is starring the reality star Chance. He had the show One More Chance of Love, I believe that's what it was called. Well, now it is titled One More Chance, and it is airing on Zeus. This season, it follows Chance and a group of girls that are in a house in LA, and they are all fighting for the chance to win Chance's heart. There are several different types of women on this platform, honey, and they're all type of characters. One is called, you know, Roly Poly Snacks because she's heavy set. One is called Yummy because, you know, she said that her the JJ was yummy, and one is called Cheeks because she has a nice little booty, and one is named She-Ra because she can do all types of flips and kicks and jumping jacks and whatever the hell else. So we've been watching that on my platform, and, you know, it's pretty entertaining. However, there is one character that seems to be getting a lot of attention and that seems to be getting a lot of questions, and I'm sure everybody knows it is the character Mangina. Now, Mangina is supposedly a transgender woman, meaning born a male and transitioned into a female. Now, judging by the looks of Mangina, which already the name is just heavily offensive, but we will get into that. But judging by the looks of Mangina, you can clearly see that this is just Zeus's attempt at shading the trans community. And what I mean by that, now, if you're going to put a transgender woman in the house, this transgender female should be able to compete with the other females that are in the home. This boy clearly is a drag queen with a wig on. He clearly is very masculine, clearly is not on any type of hormone, T-block, estrogen, nothing. This is a male that shaved his face right before the cameras went on and threw a wig on, okay? And the problem with this is that a lot of the audience constantly questions, is Chance bi? See, now, what they thought was going to be a joke and was going to be a prank and people were going to laugh and it was going to be made for, you know, good television, it actually is actually backfiring. It's doing the complete opposite. It's questioning Chance's sexuality. People are asking, why would he have a transgender on the show, or a male with a wig, or a butch queen, whatever you want to title him, why would he have that element on the show if he is not somehow into that? So what they actually thought was going to be a joke has actually turned in, you know, to questioning his sexuality. So I wanted to comment and do a little commentary on this subject because it opens the door and it makes for good conversation. When is too far too far? When doing reality television, when is too far just going too far for ratings and trying to get people to tune in? And I mean, you know, we could say Roly Poly Snacks because the girl is fat and she eat, you know, it's referring to, oh, feed her another snack and it'll make her happy. Oh, yummy, yummy. She's got a good vajayjay, so we're going to call her yummy. Like, you're naming people based off of your preconceived ideas and what you think they look like. So I'm going to name her this. So Mangina is a man, but wants a vagina. So we're going to call him Mangina. And you sit there as a so-called trans woman and allow yourself to be called that. That is totally disrespectful. And it completely undermines everything that trans people particularly trans women, have fought to overcome the stereotypes, the disrespect. Oh, you can misgender me anytime you want because I used to be a boy and that's what you know me as. So go ahead and call me whatever you want to call me. You can disrespect me no matter how it's going to make me feel, no matter what I'm saying that I want to you to call me and what I want to be respected as, because I want to be on TV and because I want to be seen, I'm going to allow myself to be called Mangina. That is totally disrespectful and it's completely out of line for Zeus. I'm very surprised at Zeus, and this is supposed to be ran by Ray J and Princess. These are supposed to be people, the two that, are Hollywood and reality king and queen. How are you even out here supporting a show that is going in that direction? So it's completely undoing any strides and any progress that the trans community has made. So you are actually saying that we can go ahead and we can make fun of a transgender female. We can call her male. We can say, call her bro. We can say, man, you still got that D between your legs. Like, it's totally disrespectful. You would have to head on over there to Zeus and you'd have to watch that if you want to see that. But actually, it has just sparked a lot of conversation and it has just made room for a lot of questions to be answered. So I went on Mangina's Instagram page because, I got tired of my subscribers asking me in the comments when we watch Chance, the episodes, is Chance gay? Is he bi? Does he like trans women? And I had to constantly be saying, no, it's just for the show. No, it's just for ratings. But then it was a good question. Well, who is this Mangina? So when looking up, Mangina's Instagram, I discovered that it's actually delicious. It's actually the boy that appeared in Saucy Santana's Walk 'Em Like a Dog video. And I posted that in this clip. You will be able to see that a little later in the video. You will see that he is actually a butch queen, which that means he is a gay male that does not go by she or her. He goes by he. So why, it's just that new breed of gay men that wear wigs, wear women's clothes, carry purses, get their nails done, but they have no interest in getting their penises cut off. They have no interest of fully transitioning into women. They have no interest of living as a female, but they want to dress in women's clothes, wear nails, and confuse the general public. You have trans women that their lives are being taken every day because men are, feeling inferior to trans women and feeling like, oh, I don't want my friends to know that I'm attracted to a trans woman. So after I, lay with her, or have a relationship with her, I'm gonna kill her so nobody knows. And then you have these men that are still gay that actually can blend in the community and date straight men and have DL relationships with them, but at the end of the day, take the wig off, put the wig on when they want, take it off when they want, put it on when they want. And it's just confusing the public. So if anyone that is a transgender or, male or female, they know that their gender is very important to them. Their gender is all that they, that they feel that they have control over and that they are not going to allow nobody to misgender them. So the fact that Zeus is portraying that it is okay still in 2020 to make fun of a transgender female and call her a male when she's clearly trying to live her life as a female, it is very disrespectful and it's sad for Zeus. And you got the nerve to be trying to strike somebody's channel when you don't even know how to clearly respect the transgender community. I should call for a boycott of your channel. But, you guys do what you want to do out there in Zeus land, because to be honest with you, I'm actually getting fed up with Zeus. So head on over there if you care at all to take a look at this whole Mangina character. But to be honest with you, it's sad and it's actually starting to get on my damn nerves because I'm tired of seeing this boy flaunting around with a wig on, acting like he's part of the girls, jumping up and down, making a goddamn fool out of himself, all in the name of being a transgender woman. So you guys, how do you feel about that? Drop down in my comments and let me know how you feeling about Mangina, honey, because I'm over it. I asked Mangina for an interview. I sent his ass an email trying to get the ones and twos. Like, what is it? Why would you, you know, even go on a show and pretend to be a transgender woman? What are you getting out of that? Oh, a little bag? You're that desperate for money? That desperate to want to be a D-lister? That you're going to play the part of a transgender female on a reality series? That's basically actually ratchetness and trashiness. But you're out here really living your life every day as a man. So drop down in my comments and let me know what you think about that. That's all I got to say about that, and I ain't got no more. Like, share, subscribe. Bye. Do it, baby, stick it, baby. The niggas on ain't claim to be no lady. Purple ain't got baby daddy going crazy. I said gloss and got these bitches that get shady. Hocus pocus doing tricks on the D. Do it, baby, stick it, baby. The niggas on ain't claim to be no lady. Purple ain't got baby daddy going crazy. I said gloss and got these bitches that get shady. Hocus pocus doing tricks on the D.